launches upon the war factories of the German Reich the vastest, deadliest assault the skies have ever poured upon the earth. Sweeping out from their bases, over the cliffs of Britain, the bombers carry in a single attack 15 times the weight of bombs the Nazis dropped in Coventry. I shall see to it, said Hermann Goering, that no enemy plane shall drop its bombs on German soil. They don't believe him now in Lübeck. They don't believe him in Rostock or Cologne. They cringe in factory towns across the Ruhr and Rhineland. The pilots of the Luftwaffe's fighters slash at the flanks of the Allied armadas, and the price of victory is written in blood. This operation, 12 of our aircraft failed to return. These are the weapons we must spend and keep spending for the right to win. But on the master chessboard of the RAF, plans are continued that the attack may be hammered home town by town, and new waves of planes are needed. Factories stubbornly enduring in the British Midlands, and cruise ships working day and night alike, roll from their lathes the parts and pieces that grow into bombers. Once English aircraft factories could be priced in sterling pounds. Today, they are worth the priceless value of freedom to free men. Meanwhile, across the Atlantic, the same urgent need for attacking air power launches a vast new program.
First, to increase our production rate of airplanes so rapidly that in this year, 1942, we shall produce 60,000 planes.
Germans were listening when the president spoke, but the planes roll in mounting thousands from the giant plants, and few Germans living will fail to hear the thunder of the deadly fulfillment of his promise. Canada, too, has harnessed her full industrial output to the mounting tide of aircraft production. Bombers to stalk the submarines, to range from Britain deep into the heart of the German Reich, armed to trade bullet for bullet with the Luftwaffe. Still, a wide ocean keeps the planes from their rendezvous with the enemy. There's room for few planes in the convoys plowing out into the Atlantic. So a new highway was blazed between the factories and the fighting fields. The sky bridge of the Ferry Pilot. Air bases of the Ferry Command, like the Mammoth Field at Dorval near Montreal, gather the fleets of giant bombers from the North American factories and give them to the Ferry Pilot to deliver. The Ferry Pilot is a man you've met before. He's the young veteran who plunged into the hell over Dunkirk. He's a bush pilot, a clipper captain. He'll deliver any plane, anywhere, at any time.
Gentlemen, you are to leave tomorrow morning at dawn. You will reach the base in Newfoundland in total darkness. Identify yourselves by two short flashes and one long.
The signal to land is two flares fire together. When you reach a point about here, your front tanks will be empty and you'll be switched over into your rear tanks.
And for heaven's sake, Flanagan, put your wheels down when you arrive in England.
Up before the sun, with today's batch of bombers grumbling on the aprons, the ferry pilots are ready to take a new air fleet across the Atlantic to the bomber command in Britain.
W, pilot Flanagan. You may taxi out to the west runway. You're clear to go. Aircraft C for Tom, you're clear to go. Aircraft M, pilot Cunningham, you're clear. Pilot Featherston, clear to go.
Like beads along the banks of the St. Lawrence, out over the peaceful lower reaches of the river and the blue-streaked waters of the Gulf, out from the land, out into the broad Atlantic.
You will reach the base in Newfoundland in total darkness. Identify yourselves by two short flashes and one long. The signal to land is two flat flares, fired together.
When you reach a point about here, your front tanks will be empty and you would have changed over to the rear tanks.
After that, your gasoline will get you to England, but not back to Newfoundland.
Night and Newfoundland slide behind the ferry crews. Dawn flushes along the path where Alcock, Brown, and Wrongway Corrigan found fame. Today, the ferry pilots cross the Atlantic 2, 3, 5 times in a single month, spanned in secret hundreds, racing over the plodding convoys, the swift wings of our new air might.
Flanagan, put your wheels down when you land in England.
Morning in Britain. The pilots of the ferry pool of the Air Transport Auxiliary take over the job of feeding the bombers up to the frontline British bases. American planes arrived across the Atlantic, called the ATA. British bombers built to raid along the Rhine, call the ATA. No matter who makes them or where they come from, the ATA delivers.
Morning, Talbot.
What do you know about this run up to Walbrook? I hear you going up that way.
Why, yes. In the first place, you have a gun-defended area here. You're going across it. You're supposed to miss it. And you're driving straight into a balloon barrage.
Well, we can always go around it.
God help you if you don't.
Rather embarrassing.
By the way, I believe you're riding with me in the Whitley.
Yeah, from Walbrook to Park Gate. Where is Park Gate? The aerodrome's around here as thick as fleas on a dog's back.
9972 is outside, huh?
Good, we'll get going then.
Anderson, 9972, Pilot Douglas, waiting outside for Thompson, Talbot, Mollison, Carter, Smith, and Felton.
Last night, the Hudson bomber swept in from Montreal. This taxi plane ferries the pilots who will take them to the bases where they're needed. Last night, the Whitley factory at Walbrook finished a batch of long-range bombers. They need one at Park Gate. The taxi plane takes a ferry pilot out to make delivery. Of the ATA land to collect a bomber.
Half a second, Alabama. Here comes Alex. This ought to be worth watching.
They take the aircraft over. Then they find out what kind it is and how it flies.
Is the test pilot around?
Yes, sir.
My name's Thompson. I've come to collect this aircraft. I haven't flown a Whitley before. Any snags?
Well, what have you planned?
Oh, Wellington's, I suppose, about the nearest.
Well, hydraulic controls, flap and undercarriage are on the different side. Your trimmer controls are central instead of on the left hand. And throttle and mixture, right handed instead of left.
the wheel's still the same, I
think. No, that's a different shape, too.
Well, but how does she handle?
Oh, perfectly. There's one thing to remember coming in, that you've got a lot of aeroplane behind you. And don't try and rush it on the ground. Let it land itself quite naturally.
Okay.
Here's something. This is more like it. Here they come. On sound. On sound.
Now, for heaven's sake, when you're coming into land, check green lights, undercarriage down and lock, propellers in fully fine pitch, and that your speed does not drop below 90, otherwise you'll fall out of your hands.
Right.
I think that's about the lot.
Thanks, all.
Okay. Hostile aircraft coming in northeast.
Raid developing. Walbrook to Park Gate area will be affected. 30 Messerschmitt 110 flying at 12,000. Warn all ferry pilots.
God's sake. This friendly aircraft's not close to me. He's going straight into there.
Hello?
Jack, we're coming in.
Coming into land, check. Green lights, undercarriage down and locked, and that your speed does not drop below 90, otherwise she will fall out of your hand.
Don't rush her onto the ground.
Jack,
we're
coming
Nice, uneventful little trip.
Boy, these airplanes sure do fly good. How did they handle? I wish I could get me one. Maybe they'll give me one before long.
Well, I shan't forget my first Whitley in a hurry.
I bet it was fun.
But you get used to them.
Such are the ferry pilots of World War II. They bind together the rivers of air power building in North America and Great Britain and deliver them to the bomber command. They put into the hands of the bomber crews the giant craft which blackened the skies above Germany with an air strength that the Nazis cannot meet, cannot defeat, cannot survive.